Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making sausage pinwheels. Now this is an appetizer. It kind of looks like a cookie, so sometimes people will walk around and pick up one and expect something sweet, but this has sausage in it and kind of a biscuit dough, but it flattens out and is a pinwheel, so it may look like a cookie to you. We'll get started with a large bowl, and into that we're placing 2 cups of self-rising flour. If you just have all-purpose flour, use 2 cups of all-purpose flour and then add in 1½ teaspoons of baking powder and 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and you'll be at the same place I am. Now I'm going to add some cold butter. We have 3 tablespoons and I have put them into cubes so that they will be a little easier to integrate into the flour. And I'm going to use a pastry blender and just start blending. If you want to do this in a food processor, that's fine, but we need this crumbled so that it looks like coarse cornmeal. So here we have our flour and butter mixture. Looks good. And I'm going to add 2/3 cup milk. Use any kind of milk that you like to use. And stir that in. So you stir this until it comes into a ball, and the last part of the blending you may want to do with your hands so you can actually feel that ball. Then you're going to bring it out onto a clean surface that has been floured. So you can just shake some either all-purpose flour or self-rising flour on a board where you're going to roll this, or in my case it's just on the countertop, which was cleaned thoroughly. And then you're going to knead it a little bit before it gets rolled out. So just flatten it and then fold it over and turn just a few times. When your dough becomes slightly elastic and easy to manage, then pick it up and redistribute your flour underneath. Add more if you feel like you need it, because you want to have flour between the dough and your rolling surface. And put a little flour on the top before you start rolling. Then take a rolling pin and roll until this is about 1/4 inch thick. And I'm shooting for a rectangular form. It doesn't really matter what size it is. I'm just looking at the thickness, and it should be even everywhere. Here is our rolled out dough. And you can see it's not perfect in terms of the edges. It's not a perfect rectangle. If you want to, at this point, you can actually cut off the edges so that you don't have to deal with them. I think I'll just go ahead and leave them like they are, and things will just work out as they do. The sausage needs to sit out at room temperature for a little while. This is 1/2 pound of just pork sausage. You can get the kind that has sage flavoring or some other flavoring. You can get the hot sausage or mild. I think this is mild. But after it is set out at room temperature, then you'll be able to mash it with a fork. If you take it from the refrigerator, that would be a little difficult, but you want it to be spreadable, so I'm just mashing it to make sure that it is of the consistency that I need, and then I'm going to spread 1/2 pound on this amount of dough. Now, if you prefer, you can use a whole pound. It just depends on how much you want. You just want a fairly even coverage of your biscuit dough. And come pretty close to the edge. All the way is fine, but if you don't make it quite there, this is all just going to be in a pinwheel that does not have to be exact in the first place. Now, to get the pinwheel, we need to have a roll, and we'll start here at the edge, and just the farthest piece out gets rolled first, and then it kind of gets lined up as you go toward the edges. Keep rolling and keep it fairly tight. You don't want big loose holes in it, but as you continue to roll, you'll have to adjust and keep it straightened up. So there is not nearly as much rolled under here as there is here, but it doesn't matter. It will all come out fine eventually. So I'm coming down to the end, and I think I will go ahead and straighten this up a little bit on the very end. That means we're just going to get rid of this little strip here, and that will end up a little nicer. And I will cut these edges when we get it finalized. When you get that last part of the roll, turn it over until the seam side is up, and then you might want to take some water and use it as glue along with the flour that you have on your dough, and make sure that that seam stays together. Actually, it would have been better if I hadn't had the sausage coming out, but all in all, it's not really going to matter. Cutting off this end just so it looks a little nicer and is all about the same size as the middle, a little bit smaller, but about the same size. And cutting off this end, which is fairly large, it gives you a roll that looks nicer. Now you can bake up these pieces separate if you would like to, but what we're going to do is transfer this to a piece of plastic wrap, and then we will roll it up and put it in the refrigerator for a few hours, about 3 or so. If you'd like, you can put it in the freezer and it won't take that long. So we'll be back to work on this, and you'll see where the pinwheels come from when we get back. This is my roll of dough that has this sausage spread inside, and I actually put it in the freezer this time, and I left it for about 1.5 hours. So this is the result you could expect. And you unroll it, unwrap it, and you can see the bottom side where we had sealed that together, but with it frozen or chilled, it will not be a problem at all. And you just go to either the center and divide it into two pieces and work that way, or you can just go to one end and start cutting slices and make them the same size the best you can. Of course, the circumference is already determined, and that doesn't matter. They can be small or large, but the thickness does matter when they're baking in the oven. So I'm going to do about 1/4 inch, maybe a little more. And I'm using a chef's knife because it just goes straight down and makes that nice pinwheel. You're going to put this on an ungreased baking pan. There's going to be plenty of grease coming from the sausage as these cook. So just continue to do that until you use up the dough or fill up the pan. Here we have our pinwheels, and you can see there are 24 of them. There was a little dough left over, and I put it in a little separate dish that we will do, but you can expect to get about 24 cut in about this way. Now, these will rise up a little bit because they are like biscuits. Also, the sausage will cook as they are in the oven. So we're going to take these to a 350 degree oven and let them bake probably for about 15 minutes, but I'll keep an eye on them because when the sausage is done and these start to brown off, that's when I want to remove them from the oven. I've just removed my sausage pinwheels from the oven. They did bake for 20 minutes altogether. The last minute I turned the oven to broil in order to have a nice brown top to them, and I didn't want them overdone, so I took them out. You might want to have them a little browner than this. Once you get them out, while they're still hot, take a spatula and go underneath them and then remove them to paper toweling so that any excess fat from the sausage can drain. It doesn't look like there's going to be any because they're pretty much stuck right here on the baking pan, but I'll go through this step and then I will be removing each one of these to a nice serving plate. So when I come back, they'll be on the serving plate. Here are the finished sausage pinwheels, and I decided to pair them with sage. So I just ran out to the herb garden and got a couple of sprigs of sage and put them there. Now these are very hot, so the sage will kind of wilt quickly. So I did it mainly so you could have a nice picture of it. But I'm gonna pick out a couple here and put them on my serving plate and show you how I might serve them. Here I have some hot tea that is steeping. It's actually lemon tea, so I think that will be good. And then I like to have the sausage pinwheels with some kind of mustard. My favorite is a sweet dipping mustard, and my favorite brand is Herlockers. Didn't happen to have any of that, but I had some fresh Dijon mustard, and I'm just going to put that in a little dipping dish here to the side. And then I will just eat these with my hands, but I want to show you what the inside looks like, so I'm going to use a knife to cut through and let you see. The sausage has to be done. So you look at the edge there and make sure it's not pink, but it's nice and brown like you would expect a sausage patty to cook up. And then the biscuit part should be a little bit crunchy because it's cut thin and it's baked kind of like a cookie instead of a biscuit. But it's nice and brown and should have that flavor coming through. So I'm just gonna take this as my bite. I will do it without the mustard first, and then I'll try it with the mustard. It's very nice. It's kind of like a sausage biscuit because you get the biscuit and the sausage together in equivalent amounts. Really good. I'm going to dip this. Mustard just perks up the flavor a little bit. It just seems to be a great complement to this particular appetizer. If you don't like mustard, of course you don't have to use that. You could serve this like as part of breakfast. You could put orange slices around and just do the whole breakfast brunch deal if you want. But I usually think of them as appetizers, and that tastes really good with the mustard. I think you'll like it. I hope you have a use for this recipe, and I hope you enjoy it.